file. I think the consensus was, when we talked about it, when we brought it up before, that we want to approve it. You know, it was like, oh, well, you know, you don't need to approve it. If you don't even want us to receive and file it, then we won't even receive and file it. And I don't remember the vote on that, but I guess I would rather, I would like to revisit that then, because I guess I'd rather see it, even though it's after the fact. Not real crazy about it being after the fact, but if that's the rules, then, you know, I'm a rule person, so I just want to know what the rules are and why. You know, I want to look into this a little bit further, and it's one of the things on my list to do. So if we, through the chairman to our secretary, could you look up that vote for me, Ms. Burden, and let me know when that was, and so the correct person, you know, the people who said yes or no can reconsider. Is that how it goes, Chairman? Yeah, we have someone in the affirmative, or?
Well, let's think, similar to, you know, what we said about, let's capture the TIFA issue, right? So you'd ask Corporation Council to review, right? What one of those being, you know, by the way, you know, you did such a great job in the last one, I had to get more work. So the you know, roles, I think your question, you know, roles and responsibility, you know, how that the structure was set up, maybe you already have notes on this end, probably better than mine. You know, the difference in receive and file, and can we change that?
Yeah.
Under TIFA, can we change it that we have to, you know, if they vote in the affirmative, we also have to vote in the affirmative. I think that's, because this is an example we can probably talk about, but I think allowing somebody to go off, do the research, and bring it back, and have a discussion is probably best at this point.
Sure.
Yes?
And not to say that we would vote against it. You know, because, you know, they're doing their job, they're researching it, they're doing their job, so, you know, I'm not trying to say they're doing anything wrong, is what I want to say. My, in addition to the opinion, or within the opinion, I would like it to be addressed about versus the charter, okay? The decision, you know, that you're going to opine, about that it's only the TIFA can do this, I want to see how that compares to our charter.
Well, and just thinking of an example, right? TSX went through TIFA, didn't it?
Believe so, yes.
Yeah, and my brother voted against that. So I know at different times, the council has voted on the items, right?
I know what they did too. So, because I was here.
Yeah, let's.
But you know what? It's a new day, so things can change. Let's see where we're at with it now. You know what we can do.
Councilor Rand.
Can we get our $8 million check from the county yet for that settlement? Wasn't it around $8 million we agreed upon out of the 30 or something like that?
Yep. Through the chair to Councilman Pettis. We got a small portion. think it was 57,000 and some changes what was approved for the two units, not to exceed amount, which we won't exceed, and then we never execute. So they can do service render, they can submit invoices, well, we can say, yup, the paint's been put on, I can physically see that. So they can never get full payment until the job's complete. So I think roughly they've received about 50% of the work that's been completed, so they're still only half of the project financially.
These two checks are in excess of 50,000.
So yeah, again, I was guessing what the number was because I wasn't prepared for the train car to loose. I could go back and look.
You're supposed to remember it.
And then I wish I could remember that. I do know they've submitted some invoices. There's a little bit of work left, basically paint, the paint is a big part that's left, but they've completed a huge portion of the work. They've got all the wood replacement, the roofing, the trim, all that's been done. They're just down to paint now, but there still is a pretty substantial amount of money owed to them, a substantial paint, but owed to them, and that won't be paid until the work is completed. That's the final nail.
If you could follow up on that, and let us know how, where we're at financially, on what we originally approved.
Absolutely.
As opposed to what we've paid.
Yep, I can tell you what's left on the approval and what's been executed to this point. I'll have that for you.
Okay. Before I go, Mr. Ewan, you're coming up and talked about maintenance. I know I brought this up before, but as I was walking in tonight, the city hall comes. So, as I'm getting ready for the things I've got to do around my own house, that was one of those big, the flaking concrete or steel. As you're going in the winter, even a can of Rust-Oleum is better than leaving it in the shade. Push the rocks out of the way, spray it. It may not be the exact matching color, but that's just something. Every time I walk in the city hall, I see, I notice. And going into next year, we've got to decide what we want to do with the area outside the council chambers.
The wall.
Yeah,
the wall.
To the point, we do have another wall that is failing. We go out to the porch here through this atrium. That wall is starting to also shift. I noticed that the measures have been taken to try to mitigate it a little bit, but it's going to need to come off, be replaced also. Moisture gets behind it. I don't know when the renovations exactly happened in the 90s, but you can tell some things are starting to, the walls are tricky. Once they start to move, it's not to stop them. That shit's happening.
Well, everything is probably about 25 years since.
Slowly but surely, I see it all. I do apologize. I'll make sure those are resolved. I did end up on the list. I'll make sure those get corrected.
Through the chair, I think Johnny's got something.
We
talked about it.
Yes. Since you mentioned it to me when we walked out that day, now I can't unsee it. So every day that I look at it, and I wouldn't have probably done
it. I can promise you, I don't see the things that we get done. I only see what's not done myself. So
that's true. So not to knock. And maybe we can talk about what's the solution. My thought out here is almost not to fill it in because you have the same problem with pressure, but you put a false floor.
We're going to get
there.
Regular deposit jacket and put a rubber mulch. So the deposit jacket will be a foot from the top to use very minimal product.
Yeah.
Plus the water will bleed through with that.
Yeah. So it's a false, false bottom. Cool. Absolutely. Yeah, because you don't want to fill it back in with dirt and pens.
Right. We don't want to help here. Thank you, guys.
All right. Thank you. All right. Any other discussions on the regular agenda? 6:30, 7:40. The second item we had is on the bid quote and purchasing policy review. The item that you're going on, no, that's fine. You're always listening. The letter from Mr. Plato is attorney-client privilege. We would have to go in a closed-door session on that, and then I think once that is done, it probably be self-explanatory. What we could do prior to that is, or
Yes.
Ms. Winston?
Yes.
And Mr. Geist?